to Conversations with CASA, a series exploring issues and trends in child welfare. My name is Vicki Spriggs, and I'm the CEO of Texas CASA. We're filming in our offices here in Austin, Texas. And our guest today is Tara Perry. Tara is the CEO of National CASA, and she's held that position since 2015. For the past 25 years, Tara has been at the forefront of numerous large-scale change initiatives and innovative program developments. Prior to joining National CASA, Tara served as Vice President of Strategy and Operations for the Woodruff's Art Center in Atlanta, Georgia, the nation's third largest art center. Tara previously spent more than 10 years with the American Red Cross in Atlanta and Chicago, as well as the national organization in Washington, D.C., where she developed a statewide preparedness strategy and had direct oversight over a $20 million capital campaign. Thank you for joining us today, Tara.
Thank you for having me.
And you flew in early this morning from Seattle.
I did.
Well, again, double thanks then.
You're welcome.
Can you tell me your proudest accomplishments since being CEO of National CASA?
That's easy. 2016. National CASA and the CASA movement saw record numbers in increases in the number of children served, increases in the number of volunteers recruited, an increase in the number of volunteers retained, and also we beat the national average in reunification and permanency for children. So that by far is the greatest accomplishment of any CEO. Certainly nothing that we at National CASA did, nothing that I did, but it's the movement. It's the power of 938 programs, state organizations and local programs coming together with this clear focus that every child deserves to have an advocate, someone that has a voice for them when they don't have a voice, when they're faced with odds that are unthinkable, and when they're involved in a system that they barely understand. So that by far is my greatest accomplishment. I hope I'll be sitting here next year saying 2017 was a great year as well.
Super. Thank you. So, given successes, what do you see as your greatest challenges?
Oh, wow. So I would say opportunities. I think that this CASA movement has a great opportunity to really leverage the sheer numbers and unify. This is a spectacular movement, and I don't think that we have realized that our greatest asset is in numbers, in reach, the fact that we are serving in 49 states in the U.S. I think that with that size comes opportunities for us to ensure that the brand is protected, that we have the same quality of advocacy from Florida to Washington State. And sometimes that leaves a lot of opportunities. We have smaller programs, we have larger programs. So I think the challenge is ensuring that high level of quality advocacy. And then one final thing I'll add to that, Vicki, is sustainability. And this is not unique to CASA, our movement, but I think garnering the level of resources that we're going to need to serve more children, to eventually serve all of the children in the system, and being able to sustain that level of support. So I would say that those are probably two. You asked me for one, but I have to offer those two as the greatest challenges.
Super. Thank you. And it just seems to me we have 254 counties in Texas,
yes.
71 programs providing services to 217 of those counties. And in Texas, every county has its own personality.
Yes.
So when you say 938 programs mm-hmm. across the United States, you know, 49 of them having state offices and the rest being local programs, mm-hmm. I'm surprised that dealing with the individual characteristics of the different states, let alone the counties within the states, but the different states isn't a major challenge.
It is. It is quite a challenge. I say something very simple. We have 938 programs and we have 938 programs because they are each very unique. They also have their own challenges locally at the state level. So it's a beautiful movement. It's a great opportunity to have that number of programs operating around the country, but it again absolutely comes with its challenges.
Yeah. So what's your vision? What do you see as you look down the future, down the road to the future? What is your vision for what you want to see happen?
Vicki, I see CASA and the advocates that we train, us having enough of those advocates that every child that finds themselves through no fault of their own before a judge in a court system will have someone there, a CASA advocate, to speak and partner with them to help them through a process that is overwhelming to us. So we can imagine that it would be overwhelming for those children. So that's my vision, very simple. And I believe based on 2016 and the growth that we saw in the network, we can do that. We're not far away from that, and I believe we can do it.
Super, thank you. I guess I'll ask you one last question,
okay,
which is, is there something that you would like to relay to our viewers that I haven't asked you?
I would say I would like to, first of all, offer thanks. One of the things that I realized, and you mentioned in the introduction that I worked in the Red Cross system for many years, and I used to always say that, oh my goodness, the Red Cross, these volunteers are incredible. These are the most dedicated volunteers that I've ever worked with. Well, I've had to change that a little bit and say that for the CASA advocates. Because this is tough work. This isn't easy. It's not episodic. You don't come in and you know, serve a kid or take them to the a ball game and then, you know, that's your interaction. This is long term. This is an emotional investment. This is really investing into the long term outcomes of a child's life. So I would say thank you for all of those that have advocated in the past, those that are involved now, those that can't make the commitment, but that support CASA in other ways. I would say thank you. That would be what I would extend to the viewers, those that are in the community, and also those that are in Texas in this network, and those that are across the country.
Tara, thank you so much for being here with us today.
Thank you for having me. It's always a pleasure to be in Texas.
No, thank you. It's always a pleasure to have you here in Texas, and we really appreciate your leadership.
Thank you.
And thank you for joining us today for Conversations with CASA.